Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Hard mode runs. Random. Please don't give me the lost. I don't know what I'll do. I guess, I'll try it, I guess, but we'll see. Just getting my post-it note prepared. I got my own post-it notes game. I don't need your post-it notes to tell me what I got done and not done. That is not gonna be the lost. It is gonna be Eve, which I'm relatively happy about. I don't really love being on an XL floor as Eve because it means that unless we find an arcade, Z32P, TCDE, sorry, just communicating with the numbers station. I am a British MI6 intelligence agent, as you might expect. Intelligence agent? Doesn't really sound like me, let's be honest. Well, you know what? They only do half damage. We might as well, if we're going to take red heart damage right off the bat, we might as well just enter Horror of Babylon state so we have the extra damage bonus, is my philosophy. Please, bomb spider, thank you. We are in the cellars. The things, you know, they get a little risky here. My hope is that we find some item rooms right off the bat, and maybe we'll get lucky enough to find, like, some decent spacebar items, like a Book of Revelations. We still do need to get that Guppy Dream. Not Guppy. Meat Boy Dream. That was a little dangerous there. That's okay. We, you know, we beat a whole Lost Run without getting hit. We should be able to not get hit twice as Eve here, if I had to guess. Kind of would prefer to find our boss rooms before we, or sorry, our item rooms before we go through with this boss room here. I really feel as Eve that, there's been some not so nice words exchanged between me and Eve as a character. But people are always like, hey, if you don't get Eve, that's because you don't understand the value of Horror of Babylon. Nah, dog. I understand the value of Horror of Babylon. And I understand that that's like the principal thing that most of the time you should be worried about trying to maintain. That being said, you know, to make Horror of Babylon work, it's kind of a niche thing. I'm gonna just love having that money. Like, not every run has the... No. has the capabilities of making Horror of Babylon happen. So I think it's kind of a bullshit defense to fall back on. That's, for once, I'm not using a straw man argument. There have been people who have said that. Maybe not directly to me, but anyway. I feel like with Eve, you benefit from being realistic. There's two paths to success. There's multiple paths to success. There's two common paths to success. Horror of Babylon scummery, which is good, you know, that's the way the character should be played to make them unique. Or, just your standard, you know, deal with the devil, doesn't really matter that you have Horror of Babylon because you have, like, Brimstone or Mom's Knife or something like that. Unicorn Horn is okay. With no spacebar item, I would rank it decently, and Pyro is good. So I feel great about that. Ooh, baby, that is exceptionally lucky. So that allows us to stay in our Horror of Babylon state while not being too at risk of death or dismemberment. That is our secret room. Inside of our secret room, we find a key beggar who I am going to explode the shit out of. Half of a red heart is what you think that's fair recompense there? Super pride with a bunch of little toxic poops. It's kind of a dangerous room here. But it gave us a tarot card. Tarot card is the stars, which we'll use probably on the next floor, but it's also possible, because we're going so quickly here, you might want to save it. It's a hive mind. I think we're just going to buy this. We're at 888. Oh, it's perfect. Yeah, I think we're going to save it and maybe try to use it against our, or on our boss rush room to just get a free item. Figure, you know, we got a little extra time and a lot of extra bombs. Might as well check for a second secret room where we pick up another black heart. So our deal with the devil chance is great if you ignore the fact that we took that red heart damage right off the start. Which we did to get into the Horror of Babylon state after I got hit once, being kind of an idiot. So these, with the unicorn horn, these little haunt babies here are going to be the hardest part of the fight. There we go. Now we're going to pop unicorn horn, and that should finish this bad boy off pretty easily. Don't think you can sneak by me, Mr. Man. Almost got hit at the end there, but that's okay. Hey, latchkey's alright. The luck upgrade plus the key consumables. Don't mind it. And we could buy a battery and get, like, another unicorn horn charge. But let's save a little bit of our money. You know, I would like to donate at some point over the course of this run. I would love to get a deal with the devil here. I don't think it's likely. And I'm not going to be too salty about it because we have so many, like, extra extraneous hearts here that we'll probably have a very good chance of getting a deal with the devil on the next floor. Yeah, so this is fine. Tears plus shot speed up is A-okay in my book right now. We could also use the stars card to teleport out of a curse room if we want to. But I'm just going to visit the curse room. I really like the idea of using it It's worth it. I really like the idea of using it on the boss rush room and just snagging a free item and getting out of there. Red chests. Those ones, you know, you could probably forgive me if I swore a little bit from those ones because they were not particularly strong. Please don't be telepills. You're not dead yet. Oh, there we go. You got like one hit left in you. Just, yeah. Oh, never mind. I had them a little confused. This is okay. We're going to take this pill right at the end of this room. Hopefully it's not telepills. Or if it is, hopefully it takes us someplace nice. Balls of steel, even better. Temperance. The temperance card is really good. I think the stars is a little better. But I can understand the value of this temperance card, especially for keeping us in Horde Babylon state if we accidentally pick up like a red heart or something like that. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it, which means I probably will not worry about it. But maybe I'll play it a little bit on this floor to get some money. Maybe that'll give us some extra donation fuel. We are closing in on 900, which is awesome. And once we get to 999, I think that's where we unlock the last shop-based item in the game. It's taken me longer than most to get there. It's all right. You know what Dr. Dre said? He takes his time to perfect the beat. I'm taking my time to perfect the, you know, general store for merchandise and wares. Actually, you know what we should do with our temperance card is play the shit out of it with Unicorn Horn. We're unlikely to need this invincibility for whatever bosses we end up facing here. You know, no matter who they are, it's pretty unlikely. Wow, that was fast and shitty because I ruined my Horde Babylon state not thinking about it. No matter what boss we face, we're probably going to find ourselves in an easier time than we would if we were going up against the Haunt. So I'm not concerned about that. I would love to get a bomb synergy that is not Mr. Boom here. Like a passive bomb item, because we already have 98 bombs. So if you would be so kind as to give me one more, that would be great. Thank you. That's what I asked for specifically. So that was, you know, and I realized that when I ruin my Horde Babylon state and then in the next breath go on to shit talk Eve, that doesn't really hold a lot of value, right? Because I'm not playing Eve properly. But it's just a mistake. It's okay. That's why I'm hoping that on this floor we'll be able to give up two or all of our hearts in order to put ourselves permanently in that Horde Babylon state and also get the added value of having whatever deals with the devil items they wanted to give me in the first place. I almost want to use Unicorn Horn on this room because it's annoying. That's okay. We probably should be blowing up more mushrooms. Like, with this many bombs, I don't value mushrooms that highly. Rub some people the wrong way. But we got Tears Up, followed by Tears Up. You know what? That was well worth it. You never know, though. Like, Magic Mushroom, if it showed up, could be amazing for us as well. So, sure, let's blow up as many mushrooms as we can easily get our hands on. Revenge Fly is an amazing item. Just a little too fast for my own good on that one. Yeah, Revenge Fly is incredible. It is basically... if I could trade in Dead Bird for like 5 cents, I would at this point, because we have a much better version of it. We don't need anything on this room, but it might be helpful to buy the Steam Sale if we can. Steam Sale is not the most popular item in the game, but if we can buy the Steam Sale, that'll make it easier for us to buy things in the future without putting ourselves at risk of not being able to donate so much. Anyway, this has been a bad floor. I haven't handled myself very well here. Going up against Pestilence, a third level Meat Boy is a legitimate possibility. Theoretically. Or a third level Bandage Girl, I guess, in this case. Sure, Goathead. Goathead's not what I was looking for because it does mean that we're going to have to go at least one more floor without being in the Horde Babylon state. But long term, this might be the best thing we could possibly hope for because it'll guarantee that we can stay in the permanent Horde Babylon state as long as we get deals that actually cost us. Ooh, store credit. It'll break as soon as we walk into the shop, right? Or if as soon as we buy something with it. I mean, we can only buy one item. We should buy the Steam Sale. That way we can donate in the future and it didn't cost us anything. I think it's a reasonably good pickup. I'm not going to look for the secret room. I'm just going to move along here. So yeah, I made some mistakes on that floor, but Goathead is a good pickup and I'm excited to have it. There's only so many deals with the devil that we can get that are not good. You know, like we're going to pay the Krampus tax at some point in the near future probably. And after that, all we gotta worry about is deals with the devil that are exclusively red chests, which unfortunately show up with alarming regularity. But we'll, you know, knock those out as soon as we can, and maybe we can get some items from them, or at least some spirit hearts. All I'm really worried about is getting into that Horde Babylon state. Once we get into it, staying into it with the goat head should not be so difficult. The downside to Revenge Fly is that you have to get real freaking close to use it as an orbital. It's not really meant to be used as an orbital. It's kind of meant to be used as a, you know, it's not meant to be used as an offensive orbital, I should say. It's meant to be used as kind of a, like a revenge type of item, you know, that thus explaining the name. But I do like using orbitals offensively when the mood strikes me. And the mood is striking me a little bit because our individual tiers don't do that much damage. Are we really going to come back up here for the unicorn horn charge? Like, that's what I struggle with right now. We were like a half second away from that being proper. We're not going to go back, even though there is a battery up there. Okay, I'll tell you what. If we find an arcade, maybe we'll go back. But I'm frustrated with my lack of ability to move through there. Probably should have just decided to eat the chance of taking half of a heart of damage instead of trying to beat it on the spikes and thus taking a full heart of damage. Anyway, we're going to maybe get ourselves into the Whore of Babylon state right now. Or maybe pick up Krampus's head, which would probably be better than the unicorn horn. Or pick up Lump of Coal, which would just be, you know, an objective net positive for us. Probably one of the worst unicorn horn charges I've ever seen there. I'm throwing a little bit here, I'll admit. I think my hatred of Eve is becoming like a self-fulfilling prophecy. Speed upgrade, that's a good one. Big fan of that. Where's that? Oh, there it is. Okay, it had to happen at some point. Doesn't really matter what it gives us. We should be using way more bombs. We have pyro. Enjoy it. Okay, Krampus's head we are going to rush with here. Rush with? I don't know what I'm talking about. It's a nice item. We should be blowing up these mushrooms for balls of steel and other such goodness. Amnesia's not really what I was looking for. Come on, magic mushroom. It's our last floor to really make it count there. Pretty good. I'll live with it. You know, we do have bandage as an orbital. We should probably be using that one a little bit more productively. So we're going yet another floor without a deal with the devil. Without Whore of Babylon. But this should be the last one. We gotta get some kind of deal on the next floor. Assuming we live that long. Very happy to have Pretty Fly. Okay. This is where the bandage comes in. This is just like hemorrhaging damage for no reason. Don't be so aggressive. You're trying to be aggressive. I'm like diagnosing myself here. You're trying to be aggressive because you're used to having Whore of Babylon. You're frustrated that you're not doing a lot of damage because you got rid of Whore of Babylon. You weren't hugged enough as a child, and now here you are. Don't lose your spirit hearts, man. That's the crux of your survivability on this run. But hey, at least this one's a little bit more exciting than the runs that have come before it. All we need is like Abaddon or something, and then the run becomes a near win by default. That is definitely enough money to buy anything from the shop, which we've got to be approaching soon. Oh, okay, this is great. So as long as we don't lose all of our spirit hearts, we can put ourselves in the Whore of Babylon state, whether the game wants us to or not. And there goes our spirit heart. It took me a second to process that. We don't want Hookworm, really. Where is our deal with the devil? Or not deal with the devil. That's another question I can ask myself, but you know, we did just have it. But where is my my item room shop corridor here? The keys are nice, but it's not what we need. There we go. It's not our shop, which is maybe what I'm more looking forward to, but it is what it is. Item room contains... It didn't let me pick it up for a second. I was like, really? Blood of the Martyr. Blood of the Martyr is good and does not require us to be chained to a low amount of HP in order to use it. That's good. There is our shop. Finally, I recognize that there's a key back there I didn't pick up. That's okay. It happens. We'll go pick it up right after we leave. It's not like we're going anywhere. 12 minutes. What are we on here at 12 minutes? Catacombs 2? How many hits does this guy take? Spirit art for sale. No spirit art for sale. Nothing at all for sale here. Catacombs 2. So I still think boss rush is a likely possibility. No steam sale there, as expected, I guess. I'm hoping that maybe we end up coming across a demon judgment. And with this demon judgment in the arcade, that is. And maybe a fortune teller. If we do come across that, we've got good chances here. Well, how do you feel about this one? I feel that we blow these guys up. Don't risk walking on the spikes by accident, for God's sake. Maybe get a spirit heart out of you. I'm not gambling on you anymore, that's for sure. We can take the red heart if we want to, but I'm nervous about it. I'm nervous about the lack of HP we have as is. You know, one enemy well-placed could kill us. We've already blown up all the mushrooms here. Alright, well, this is the situation we're in. You know, we've made our bed, time to lie in it. Down to the next floor, this could be the end of this run, or it could be the start of something wonderful. To have a spirit heart would be very nice, though. Alright. Oh, I'm a little faster than I give myself credit for there. We should slow down. Like, a lot, because that nearly got me killed. It is worth noting, you know, if I walk over a spike, I'll die. So maybe just, yeah, just take a second. And, you know, let yourself kind of slow down when you enter these rooms. Why am I not using my stars card to get to the item room? I still hold on to the idea that we can get very good returns on our investment there. Probably should not have stood anywhere near that. We can get pretty good at returns on our investment if we just, instead, use it to steal a free item from the boss rush room. We don't have Whore of Babylon. Or no, we do have Whore of Babylon. We don't have Lump of Coal. Blank of Blank. I knew we were missing one of the Blank of Blank items, but it still seems to make sense. You know, with decent range comes, you know, less responsibility, funnily enough. So we'll just stand back as far as we can. It's all good. Stay back as far as we can. Don't worry about the poops. If you don't get hit, hey, we had that lost run, you know? I know all about not getting hit. If you don't get hit, it doesn't matter how much HP you have, nor does it matter how much damage the enemies do. Probably gonna say no to that fatal curse room right now. Seems like a wise choice. Very risky. The creep might do one heart of damage. Secret room? We haven't had any skulls, right? Like, we haven't missed any skulls yet. Really should be looking for tinted rocks as well. None here. Be very, very wary about doing that. Now this, that one, nub, guts, do you have it? Shoots out bullets. Scares me. He's dead now. A little nerve-wracking, I'll admit. I've been in this position before, though. That was actually probably the scariest moment on the whole run right there. We'll throw a bomb down here. I would like to get to our shop. Oh, it's on the other side of the map, you ding-dong. I was going to say I'd like to get to the shop because there's a, you know, really good chance there's a spirit heart in there. Cricket's head. This is an incredibly good item for us. That's a magician card, but maybe we are better off having the magician card temporarily. Skulls, this is where we want to be. Yeah, so our damage should be great now. What's our time like? 16 minutes? Might want to skip the shop on this floor and donate on the next... Ah, but boss rush is way less important than just getting our donations done. Hermit. Well, we could also do that, but let's wait until after we fight the boss. Which is going to happen right now. This should be easy enough. War! We're gonna get a second level Meat Boy or another Orbital. Second level Bandage Girl or another Orbital. There's our second level Bandage Girl. What do you got for me? Finally! Real items! Only this time, half of them will kill me. Should have bought a Spirit Heart in advance. I'll tell you what. With Goathead, we can come back. So we'll pick up Pentagram. We're now permanently in Whore Babylon state. Pop that Hermit card. Get this. Get this, just to keep yourself safe. You know what? Let's donate right now while we have the time to do it. And we're going to want to pick up Brimstone here. Yes. It does, you know, it puts us in a position where we pretty much can't take damage. And that sucks. But it also puts us in a position where, you know, we could fairly realistically have a good chance of winning as well. Plus, I like to play dangerously. There we go. Blackheart, that's what I'm looking for. Anything that has a good chance to keep us alive a little bit longer. Maybe should have dropped this Judgment card in the Devil Room. But I'm kind of hoping for like an HP upgrade or something. ASAP. Yeah, you know what? Forget Boss Rush. I don't think we're going to be able to do it. We might be able to with Brimstone. We're going to try out these guys for more Blackhearts or tarot cards. That's all right. Don't need them. So our damage is going to be through the roof. Question is going to be if we're going to have enough HP to actually survive afterwards. And I think it's it's not guaranteed. A little complicated. I like having the second level bandage girl. Third level bandage girl, or meat boy for that matter, don't give us any achievements. But so be it. That's the magician? It's the stars. That's what we want, right? I think, because there's still a small chance we could do this. Alright, there's our boss rush room. So we're going to take Brimstone and have 2 HP. Our damage is going to be insane, though. Our damage is going to kill everything in one room. We can't fly, and nor do we have any means of which to replenish our HP. We got to get going to the boss rush room. That's why I'm going to leave this overlay up for a moment here. We're also we're spawning this Brimstone laser in record time. HP is the most important of all attributes temporarily. It's a dead end, but that's okay. It's not going to take us too long to get through it. I do want to, you know, blow up those skulls. We'll do that after we pop our stars card. I actually think we've got it. We went from, like, no chance to boss rush to a very good chance of boss rush pretty quickly here. Because we should be able to clear this floor out in under a minute. Almost all enemies die in one hit. You know, champions or not. One hit of this Brimstone is nothing to sneeze at. You know, Brimstone's stronger than it used to be. Haven't seen any tinted rocks yet, but also have not taken any damage. We cleared out like 8 rooms in a minute. Less than a minute. I do want to go to that double key room. I do want to do that as well. Never know what kind of goodies could be contained in there. This room's going to be slower, but it also comes with a black card built in. Very nice. We got a minute. I still, you know, perhaps crazily think that's more than enough time to get this done. We're not going to go to that yet because we don't need to. Might as well pick that up. We haven't seen our shop yet either. Oh, there's our shop. Okay, so we've got to be on the way to the boss room now just by process of elimination. And there it is. Process of elimination, of course, I meant to say. Yeah, we got plenty of time here. We're already done. So we're going to take this. I guess we'll go temporarily into our devil room. I don't really want to do that one. Anti-grav. Anti-grav plus brimstone is pretty funny. So we'll stars card out now. And that's Mom's Eye, which is not very good, but that's okay. So now we can do this. Oh my god, it's actually awesome. Yeah, okay, Mom's Eye is the coolest shit of all time. Disregard what I said earlier. Does it work every time, or is it like a random chance? Because, you know, normally with Mom's Eye, it's kind of a random chance. Alright, this synergy is way cooler than I originally gave it credit for. That's awesome. It seems like it's working every time. So we can set up, like, multiple lasers, and there's just no chance anything goes wrong for us now. Minus the consequences of having basically no HP. So we're going to go to our... We're going to go to our boss rush room. We can't fly still. It's something that's hard for me to get over because I feel like I can. Guppy's head. You know what? Let's stick with Guppy's head instead of Krampus' head. I don't think Guppy's head is always better than Krampus' head. I think in our current situation, it is. And having the flies will be a nice change of pace. You know, we don't have to charge up anything extra. Oh my god, this is beautiful. Tears up. Yes, please. Speed down. A little bit less, please, but that's okay. No rerolls here. Good. Just a bunch of chests. Spirit Heart's very valuable at this point. The money, probably a little less so, but we do have to go to our shop and see. Amnesia. Not a great pill, in case you were wondering how I feel about amnesia. Again, still can't fly. I'm definitely, by the way, not going to be trading 3 Spirit Hearts for, I always say infested baby, for a headless baby. I think that is the definition of a terrible trade. I will buy the Spirit Heart here. I think I'll buy that. I think I'll buy this just to use it and get a better card. And you know what? I think I'll actually buy the battery to get another tarot card, because the tower sucks. And the Fool is also not very good, but we can use it to get out of a curse room on the cheap. Alright, let's do this. This run has turned into a very exciting run. There's nothing in there for me. It's a little bit difficult. I wouldn't tell a lie there. But at the same time, certainly one of the most interesting runs I guess we've ever had. The fact that Mom's Eye actually works here to create that sweet, like, multi-shot laser is amazing. So, like, on rooms like this, it should be automatic, basically. Just kill everything on the first hit. Well, you gotta get the second one lined up appropriately, apparently. There we go. Don't really love Curse of Darkness, but that'll give us a chance to appreciate the cool lighting effects. And we are, like, our shots are doing so much damage that the flies are gonna simplify things for me. No question about it. Oh, come on. You're not gonna finish that off? Like, look at how quickly we charge. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. It's actually pretty awesome. Okay, one for you, one for you. Bit of a strange one, but I do love anti-grav brimstone. I've had it before. There's our boss room up there. I feel bad for the bosses, man. It is just gonna be a non-stop portal to hell and back. Just gotta remember to be kind of diligent about actually putting the portals down, because there's no reason not to. Yeah, we'll definitely take Curved Horn. That shows up so rarely, seemingly. That was very easy. I'll take Cat of Nine Tails. No questions asked. You know, unfortunately, this is one of the few times I think it's not worth taking either of those items. Our HP is too precious for us right now. I don't expect to lose a lot, but at the same time, we can't afford to lose a lot. So let's keep it going here. We got like a little spaceship layout. There is no escape. Tinted rocks. I don't see any. Could always be mistaken, don't get me wrong. I don't claim to be omnipotent when it comes to finding the tinted rocks, or when it comes to anything for that matter. Man, I do not want to be in this room. We were in a sweet location earlier. Where did we get charm shots from? Gotta go all the way back there now. Not that way. This way. Man, this is like the ideal room for this bullshit, even though I took damage and now feel like an idiot. These guys should not be able to offer too much in resistance. Tinted rocks. Are there any tinted rocks? I don't see any. This is like two double monstros or three double monstros? Must have been at least two, or sorry, at least three. Tinted rocks. Kind of hard to see. I don't see any. Alright, so we're going to be looking for red chests in our boss rush room, and also this little room down here. Who knows what this contains? Lots of poop. Well, luckily, we have kind of a great poop-destroying run here. We actually got a spirit heart in one of them, which I think is pretty unlikely, but very lucky. Worth the two keys, strangely enough. That is not a red chest, in case you didn't notice. And now that we've done that big room, why don't we go up that way? That's probably a little bit of a smarter way for us to approach, because we've already done the dirty work up here. I don't want to touch that blood bank. Oh, there is a tinted rock here. I'll blow it up. You know, we got the bombs necessary to do so. We got a spirit heart. We got a bad gas pill. It's got to be better than the fool card at this point. I don't really see myself going to too many curse rooms. The brimstone laser is so long lasting. Sounds like I'm doing a commercial. The brimstone laser is so long lasting. I can't believe it. But really, it's pretty much capable of killing these envies single-handedly. Like, in one charge, which is awesome. But we definitely don't want Shoop the Whoop. That item is trashed here, as far as I'm concerned. It's trashed here, and it'll give you trash tears. Like, you're gonna use a Kleenex to clean up all your crying, because it's not a very good item. There's our boss room. I thought this seemed like the proper path to take here. And if an enemy's gonna, you know, be a little bit cheesy in its own right, why don't we be a little bit cheesy back and just spam this shit down? Actually gained HP, did not expect that. Really? I'm a little surprised. I like fighting these enemies that are not mobile at all, though. Alright, now we start throwing down some delicious brim lasers in here, and Mom is already dead. If an enemy's stationary, it's too late for you, dog. Like, you're already out. If you don't move, it's too easy. Now what we need is magnetic tears. So that every... Oh, we can't fly. What we need is magnetic tears, so when we create these portals, the enemies get sucked in and they can't get away. I tried to avoid the brimstone laser. I never meant to do boo-boo. That's And I Ran, the worst impression ever of And I Ran by Flock of Seagulls. My mistake, it's a great song. I mean that sincerely. Should make sure we're popping that at all times. Locking it more optional. Boss room right there. Unexpected, but beloved nonetheless. Man, Mom's Eye anti-grav brimstone. I would never in a million years have thought that this would have been good. And it's not good. It's actually incredible. Oh, you know, it's Bandage Girl that has the charm tears. I forget about that. Well, this is like already 80% over. This is a bad day to be you, Isaac. Like, rush me down, dog. What are you gonna do? Alright, down to the chest. I'm very excited to see what kind of greatness we can encounter in these chest items, because it could make this run even better than it already is. Bob's curse not really gonna help. Sad onion, sure. Sissy long legs, it's gonna create some spiders for us. Now, stem cells is a bit of a weird one, because right now we benefit from having permanent Polaroid invincibility, so kind of feel like we should just not take stem cells, unless it's gonna kill us to avoid it. Blue Baby's Only Friend is a good item, but not really a great item for us if we can't really control where it's going to be. I am in love with this run right now. I wonder if you had this with Loki's horns, if it would actually give you... What did I get hit by there? Creep or something? If you had Loki's horns on this run, I wonder if it would actually give you like four-way lasers. Even if you didn't have Mom's Eye. Because that would be awesome. That would be the greatest shit of all time. It might be the one combination that could single-handedly redeem my faith in Loki's horns, an item that looks really cool but is otherwise usually pretty not good. Now we are taking a little damage here, you know. It wasn't necessarily unexpected. Look at that! He charged me down. That was incredible. Bang bang! My baby shot me down. Don't lose this run, Ryan. Don't lose this run. That's not the dead end I was hoping for. I was hoping for a dead end that indicated a boss room. Lucky. Not so lucky, probably, but you never know. Can we even get the golden poop here? We gotta let, like, Bandage Girl do it. Now we got Counterfeit Penny. That's perfect. Well, that last guy, I'm gonna let you live. Good. Just stay away. That's the all I need to worry about is dodging. Eventually, like, the portals will hit. I don't need to worry so much about actually getting attacking done. Mostly just stay the fudge out of the way. We don't need that money. Is this like 7 Lokis? I don't like this because they can teleport right next to me. And we got 2 out of 4 killed. That's gonna hurt, yeah. If I can just get them to stay still, we're in a great position. Okay. Should probably kill Sloth last, but I don't have too much control over that. This is very risky, man. I'm surprisingly in a bad position here. I think we're gonna have to take stem cells. But step one is not taking stem cells. Step one is stopping dumb damage on rooms where I shouldn't be taking damage, because every spirit art does matter at this point. Where is that second Polycephalus, though? Is there only one? I thought there were two. Getting a little nervous now. Waiting for this gentleman to come back. Oh, there are two. I knew there were two of them. Oh my god, that's just embarrassing now. Well, we gotta take stem cells. I almost dodged right into that. That would have been a disaster. I'm so sorry. I lost. I really thought that was gonna be fun. And it was fun. I can't believe man, one spirit heart. I should have picked up stem cells earlier, but I didn't want to ruin my permanent Polaroid invincibility. You got me, Wrath. You got me. That's a sweet bomb there. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run, regardless of my ineptitude at the end. It was a cool synergy. If you did enjoy the run, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.